chopped with Kane for what you did to Eugene. It's unforgivable. If I were paid to sit here and talk to you, I wouldn't say a word to you.
I'll show you. You'll see.
Come on, Al. Give me a hug. Give me a hug.
Don't touch me, y'all.
Are you 230 pounds? Steven Richards.
Well, I will say this, that Eugene came out on Monday night not nearly as shaken up as what I would have liked. But you got to say that it was pretty smart on my part and Eric Bischoff's part and Kane's part to get at the young kid because Eugene has got to go.
I'm ashamed of you. I'm embarrassed.
Hey, come on, baby. Come back to the real side.
Now,
come back to coach's side.
Nah, I'm not going over to the dark side. It was wrong. I don't care what you say. It was wrong.
Well, here we go.
You know, that's like trying to swindle him out of money.
We'll take everybody back to this past Monday.
I mean, granted, you make some money, but it's not a challenge, coach.
That may be the next step that I need to take. Well, here we go. Maven makes his return here to Sunday Night Heat. Now, Maven's only been back maybe once or twice that I can remember in the past 4 or 5 months with serious injuries. And hopefully now Maven can stay injury-free.
Well, it looks like the boss is making Maven wipe down. Got Jack Doan on the case, saying a little too much butter on the popcorn.
Boy, now, now Steven Richards with a cheap shot to the side of the head of Maven, and here we go.
You hear?
Hear what?
Steven Richards is going to have a little talk with Howard Finkel after the show.
Well, Steven Richards just said to Maven, welcome back.
Well, I think Steven Richards is a little upset that Maven, the MVP of Heat, was gone so long, you know. Oh, beautiful dropkick. Steven Richards a little upset that he lost his franchise player. Trying to bring Heat to another level, and then, of course, his franchise player, Maven, gone off the Heat.
Stevie Knight, Heat heading for the hills. Maven is having nothing of that whatsoever. Maven's got to be excited.
No, he's not excited. Now he's going to be constipated.
Hard into that barrier ringside in the midsection, and now the count is on Maven. Well, folks, so much to get to within the hour. Of course, we'll talk all about Bad Blood. Can't believe it's upon us already. 1 week from tonight, Columbus, Ohio, the Nationwide Arena. If you don't have your tickets yet for Bad Blood, certainly you want to get there
and definitely
get your tickets. Bad Blood, Hell in a Cell, so many other great matches. Chris Benoit and Kane, Shelton Benjamin, Randy Orton. Of course, we'll show you how that.
Oh, he made the count.
Well, I tell you what, I almost wasn't paying attention to the count. I'm glad that you were.
Wow, what a shock. You not paying attention to a match other than just yourself.
That hurts. It's not true.
Didn't the boss talk to you about that? Didn't Steven Richards take you aside and say, try to not speak about just yourself, try to speak about the match too?
And I've been doing a great job of that. Nice slamming now on the midsection, all the body weight of Steven Richards. And lately, as of late, here's the cover. Hook of the leg. Two count by Jack Doan and a kick out by Maven.
Smart wrestling on Steven Richards' part. He threw Maven against the wall, injured the gut, cut off the air, and is now staying focused right on that same spot. Got him hooked, got the abdominal stretch. That's what we like to call that, or the guillotine.
Are you through?
Yes.
Are you tired of being mad at me?
No,
because I don't appreciate it and I don't like it. We don't work well together when you're upset with the coach.
I had no choice. Look at what you did.
Well, right now, Steven Richards looking at what he is doing to Maven in that midsection. And you got to wonder, Al, with all the injuries that Maven has had as of late, if any type of substantial hold is put on him, that may re-aggravate any type of injury.
I doubt that. I think Maven's back and he's 100%. I think he just got to get back in the game, get the momentum rolling, and he'll be back on top before you know it.
And you can see the agony on the face of Maven as he attempts to try and get out of this abdominal stretch. And we've got such a lineup tonight on Heat. Evolution. Wait a second.
Maven coming out.
Oh, there you go. There you go.
Him, but man, the ribs, the gut. He put so much stress on that. Steven Richards has just put so much pressure on that abdominal area that Maven couldn't capitalize.
And Richards wasting no time, but countered nicely with an atomic drop.
Reverse atomic drop. Put the old tea bags up around the ears.
Do you like write this stuff down?
Don't have to. Comes right off the top of the head.
Amazing.
Beautiful right hand. Oh, but cuts him right off again with a shot to the gut.
Now these two men so evenly matched. What a backdrop and the impact on the lower back of Steven Richards. And Steven Richards wants a little T.O., baby, a little T.O.
And Steven Richards, he's going to need to win this match to stay in a good mood. Because if he don't, I feel sorry for Howard Finkel in that talk later.
I wouldn't worry too much about the fake.
I would. I've seen him.
Well, now Maven starting to fire up on Steven Richards. You got to wonder if fatigue is going to be a factor after such a long layoff for Maven.
And all those shots to the abdominal region, being able to get the win back.
Got it. A quick roll. That could be enough, but no, about a 2.5 count by Jack Doan. And Maven nearly had his first victory in some time.
And you can see Maven still kind of holding those ribs and holding that abdominal section. Not quite catching his wind. This could be a foolish move on his part to go to the second rope.
And now Maven up that second rope is caught. And now you alluded to it.
Wow.
Just like that, telegraphing that move, and Maven caught with a shot to the midsection.
Well, since Miss Cleo went out of business, I could open up my own Psychic Friends Network. Looks like the boss has given Maven the last rites.
Is that what you think that is? Because I had no idea what was going down right
Apparently,
now.
He's going to beat him and then fire him.
That may be it. And now setting up for this DVT.
I think he does that same thing. Oh, wait.
Ooh. Taking way too much time. That may be enough. Hook the leg by Maven, and he does get the victory. Out of nowhere. From defeat comes victory for Maven.
Here is your winner, Maven.
Well, I tell you what, Maven looks to be in tremendous shape.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Comes back in great form in his return here to Sunday Night.
Maven pulling out a reverse front Russian leg sweep. Way to go, Maven.
Plenty of action still ahead here on Heat. Evolution's Batista goes one-on-one with Val Venus tonight.
Stand back. There's a hurricane coming through.
We are back, and what a huge night it was for La Resistance last Monday night. The new tag team champions winning those tag team titles out in their own province of Quebec, Canada.
Yep, capitalizing on one mistake by Edge. That's all it took. The crowd, the Canadian crowd, was a little torn, but they definitely were on the side of the La Resistance.
The following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall in the ring at a combined weight of 565 pounds, the Hurricane and Lucy.
We got to believe that victory by La Resistance certainly has the confidence of a tag team like the Hurricane and Rosie that anybody can win on any given night. Well, folks, I can tell you that tonight, Heat is brought to you by Milky Way. Pleasure you can't measure.
Much like myself, and by Subway. It's what to eat when you want to eat fresh. Subway, eat fresh.
And by Stacker Sues, YJ Stinger. Catch the Buck, Bill Blink, Million Dollar Contest. Check out WWE.com for all the details.
Oh, I could win some money then.
$1 million.
Yeah, then maybe I'd be out of here and I wouldn't have to talk to you anymore.
You think so?
I'm still disgusted with
your you. Life would be so boring without the coach in it.
Well, true it would be. Hey, we've got Jack Karloff in there and John Lugosi. They're great-grandnephews of Bella and Boris. I'm sure you didn't realize that after their horror film careers, they became professional wrestlers.
I did not realize
and
that.
And the great-grandnephews are now taking over. Oh! Beautiful close.
Well, right now, Rosie, who is... A very lackluster, cocky cover, so to speak.
This is kind of like an Abbott Costello movie or something, because now you've got, like, the monsters facing the superheroes.
Very similar. Very similar. Here's
the
tag.
John Lugosi.
John Lugosi is going to take his opportunity against the big Rosie. Here's the tag, and in comes, for the very first time, the Hurricane.
The Hurricane coming in. Oh! Leg lariat.
Well, this one could be looking forward to even get started. A two count and a kick out. Now the Hurricane.
With this performance up. There's Jack Karloff coming in, putting a boot, now foolishly turning his back on the Hurricane. But what teamwork! John Lugosi just suckered him in.
Well, it appeared like there was the inexperience. Maybe that inexperience was what helped him that particular time.
Ow!
Al, you need to calm down. You really need to calm down. And over the top of the Hurricane and Rosie are on fire just like Al Snow.
You hear that sound?
What's that?
It's the sound of a helicopter, but it's really not. It's Bella and Boris rolling over in their graves as their great-grandnephews kill their wrestling careers.
Well, every time, I'll give Hurricane and Rosie their two.
Lugosi just continues to try. Or is that Karloff? That was Karloff on the outside. Lugosi now inside with... Oh! What a backbreaker.
Well, this one, what a huge upset.
This could be it.
Look at the leg.
Oh, stay on Hurricane. Stay on love the Hurricane Lugosi.
You know, we see this a lot of times, Al, whenever there's an experienced tag team or singles competitor in the ring, they can do a lot of good things, but there's that one point in the match where they kick themselves by having the inexperience and not staying on their opponent.
Absolutely, but that right there by Lugosi could have been the match turner. This could be a change in the tide. Jack Karloff now keeping the pressure on Hurricane. What they need to do, as I pointed out before with tag team matches, keep Hurricane on that side of the ring and tag in and out.
And Rosie is desperate to get back into this matchup as the Hurricane has all can handle. And what a shot to the midsection again of the Hurricane.
Now Jack Karloff got to keep the pressure. A beautiful drop kick. Covering. Don't play to the crowd.
Well, did play to the crowd. Here's the cover. Hook the leg. That may have cost him. And indeed, I think it did cost him. He got a two count, but nevertheless, not the three.
Now tag out to John Lugosi. Bring in the fresh partner. Use the other man to your advantage. Okay, don't listen to me. You stay in the ring, Jack. Whoa, went for the sidewalk slam, but Hurricane dropped him.
The Hurricane did indeed drop him, but you can see how much damage he has taken to the lower back, and the Hurricane is desperate to get over to Rosie, and Rosie desperate to get in.
Hurricane's got to make that tag, but Jack Karloff has got to make it to John Lugosi.
Oh. Well, there's the tag Lugosi in one corner, and here comes Rosie.
Yep, the unstoppable force.
And Rosie, two huge knockdowns, and it just seems like maybe Rosie in recent weeks has become a little bit looser. Oh, what a backdrop.
Oh, Jack Karloff from behind again.
Nice sidewalk slam, and Rosie right now seemingly a two-on-one domination.
Yeah, but my money's on Rosie because Jack Karloff really seems to favor that from behind move.
Oh, and leg drop, we ignore Al Snow, and this one could be over. Oh, but broke up from behind.
What? All the whole match, what's he been doing? Hitting people from behind.
Well, exactly, but you don't have to point that out, is my point.
That's what my job is.
And
okay.
Now all four men were in the ring as Hurricane deposited. I can't even remember these guys' names because you keep pointing it out.
It's John Lugosi who now is with a little extra help from Hurricane, taking the squisher in the corner. Got him up to the Samoan slam and into the neckbreaker. Oh!
And here's a cover by Rosie. And this one, indeed, you can put it in the books.
Here are your winners, the Hurricane and Rosie.
Well, a huge victory by the Hurricane and Rosie. And folks, earlier this week in front of a jam-packed press conference, the WWE made a huge announcement regarding the biggest event of the summer. And it's Tuesday. This Tuesday, go to WWE.com for more.
Somebody give me like a bag of ice or something. I gotta place it on my nether regions. I'm getting all hot and bothered.
These chicks are hot, kid. They're hot.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first from Detroit, Michigan, weighing 275 pounds. Rhino!
You know how you always talk about, you know, Raw and Divas and the catfighting and all that. Can you imagine the competition between over 1,000 women to win $250,000 prize? There's one winner, and the rest thing for cover.
Wait, like you weren't sitting there when you were watching that, like I was, and imagining all of them catfighting at one time?
No, I'm looking forward to that. Oh. But I'm just saying.
I was already imagining it.
Imagine if we were somebody
that's
was dangling.
Why I need the ice pack.
Well, here we go.
Hey, think about it, though. The audience of Raw get to decide the winner.
That's the huge deal.
Yeah.
You know,
why can't we decide the winner? Like, they could come and do tryouts for us.
Well, because I know what would happen. I know our way of trying people out. Oh, Rhino. Just slamming Rory McGregor.
Rory Babagunooch.
My bad.
Great-grandnephew of Rory Calhoun.
My bad. I don't know if Rory exactly knows what he's getting himself into here tonight, having to go one-on-one with this bulldozer from Detroit.
I don't know. He looks like he's like a long-lost headbanger.
He kind of does a little bit.
Doesn't he?
With the kilt and the bald head. I get that. I get that.
I certainly hope he's wearing something underneath that kilt, because I remember the headbangers never did.
Well, now Rhino and Rory Babagunooch going with the test of strength.
And my edge goes to Rhino, but Rory Babagunooch pulling out a kick to the gut, and it's slamming the back of the Rhino right into the mat.
Very impressive. Here's a quick cover, though. No hook of the leg. And early on here, Rhino able to kick out very easily. But this Rory not intimidated, at least early on, by Rhino.
Well, apparently because he's got that Scottish background. You know, they just have that hot blood in it.
But again, maybe a lack of experience. You're an idiot.
What?
Wait, it's like you came in tonight with no agenda
yes,
other than just to make me mad.
trying to get along with you because I can't stand the fact of what you did on Monday night. Thank you very much.
Well, here's another cover by Roy, but again.
And foolishly, absolutely foolishly trying to hold him down with just two hands. Ooh! And you're going to pay for that now. Oh, kick to the gut.
Rhino took a whole lot of exceptions to that, but just like that, Rhino hard into the corner.
Now you're playing right there, Rory Baba Ganoush. Do the Baba Ganoush family proud.
I know Rhino just returned after this past week. We saw this past Monday night how great the trip over to Ireland really was. And this Rory Baba Ganoush looks like he could be Irish.
Yeah, well, you know, the kilt and all.
We do want to thank all of our great fans who
enough to find out if he is Irish.
And now we're going to show everybody a little bit later on that huge trip that the Raw Superstars just made to Ireland. But right now, Rhino is firing up on Rory Baba Ganoush.
Back suplex on Rory Baba Ganoush, but Rhino still feeling some of the effects from offense that Rory Baba Ganoush has pulled out on him early on in the match.
Don't forget, Batista still to come will be in action, but right now the count is on both of these two men.
Rory kind of coming up a little quicker because, of course, he's had the pressure on a lot more on Rhino.
Well, the count now up to six as both men attempt to get back to their feet, and they do.
Rory threw the right hand so hard he almost knocked himself down.
I think he threw his back out, actually.
Well, you know, that's like hitting a brick wall when you're hitting Rhino.
There's just some ways of attacking things and some ways not to attack things, and right now, I don't know if Rory's going about it the right way.
I'd say, no, he's not.
Oh, no.
Like he's always doing is making the Rhino mad. And when you make a Rhino mad, that's what happens.
Well, here we go, and Rory Baba Ganoush.
Oh, Rory Baba Ganoush, yep, he's Irish. We can see the bottom of it.
Getting welcomed to Sunday Night Heat the hard way.
They don't call him Rhino for nothing. And not just because he has a big horn.
Belly to belly the hard way. And now Rhino in this crowd rises to his
crazy
feet. Exactly the word I was looking for.
But Val Venus has got that same look in his eye. He's not backing down.
Well, here we go. And, of course, Batista represents Evolution, which Triple H is a huge, well, the leader of Evolution, actually, as these two lock up and out. As we go through this match, I got to get your thoughts as we are just 1 week away from Bad Blood on the Hell in a Cell, the match to end it all, to settle it all between Shawn Michaels and Triple H.
Whoa. like running into a brick wall.
Come on!
But we just saw, Coach, what Triple H has done in the past in Hell in a Cell. But, hey, Shawn Michaels is no stranger to Hell in a Cell himself. He took on The Undertaker, and let's face it, The Undertaker is the person who created that match.
That is true. That is true. Valvina saying, all right, I'm digging it. I'm back into it. Here we go.
Valvina's definitely going to have to change up his strategy in his game, much like he's doing. Take the leg out. No matter how big you are, if you can't stand, you're going to fall.
Three stiff shots of those tree trunk type legs of Batista, and now Valvina.
Going to the head, but he's got to stick with the legs. There you go, back heel trip. Focus on it. Drop on that knee. Everything around it's nice and big and thick, but that joint, it ain't that strong. Break it.
You know, Al, you brought up a very, very good point.
I do agree with
that. With the fact that Val Venus is a very intelligent, smart superstar. When he's in the ring, he knows how to get it done regardless of who he's taking on. And right now, the right strategy in taking on Batista.
That's right. Keep him down on the mat and focus on taking out one body part, which the smart move is to take out that leg. There you go.
Hard knee to the back, and Batista goes through those groups and down. Through the ropes, excuse me, and roots. Down. And exactly, roots.
There was a Bob Roop one time as a wrestler.
And now Valvina's going to the outside, much of the chicane.
Took his name off. Took
referee.
His eyes off of Batista and put him on the Coyote, the referee, Mike Chioda.
And now Batista using that power that we always allude to. Probably his strongest asset is the power that he owns.
He owns it. He bought it. He paid for it. He owns it. Nobody's going to be able to take it away.
And now methodically taking apart Valvina. Valvina, a hard shot to the head, but again, Batista right back at a clothesline from those powerful, powerful arms.
Brilliant move by Batista. But Valvina has got to shake it off, get it together, and take out the leg again. Go back to work.
Batista always assessing the situation, always knowing what's going on.
But that could be a mistake. He moved in a little slow on Valvina. Beautiful suplex. About broke him in two. Now covering Batista. Do not take him for granted.
Al, I think right now we're seeing Batista want to show the entire world what exactly he can do. That's what I think we're seeing right here.
Well, believe me. He can show it by beating Valvina.
I get that. I understand that.
You know, you don't walk around and take your time in the ring. You're not getting paid by the hour. Look, Valvina's trying to fight it. He knows. Beautiful cross face by Batista. But again, backs up, kind of walks around. Got to stay on your opponent.
Well, it's that cockiness that I love from the members of Evolution. That every time they step out or every time they get in the ring out, they know they're the very best in their competing on that particular night at that particular time.
Yeah, but that cockiness is right now costing them. German Springer.
What a spine buster.
Right,
Batista, this one could be over. Two on Valvina. Gets that left shoulder up.
If he'd have snatched him up tighter on that cover, that'd have been it. Don't look at the referee. That was your mistake.
You don't have to yell at Batista. He's a very fragile individual, as you can see.
Yeah, he looks real sensitive. Oh, he's got him in the camel clutch.
And now,
man, the pressure on Valvina's back, on his neck. You can't breathe when you're like that. Look at him. He's sucking wind already. And look, Batista, the eyes rolling up in the back of the head, just pulling further back on Valvina. Val's got to get those arms loose, Coach.
Yeah, the intensity continues on the face, and you're right. Valvina, this could be the beginning of the end for this man from Las Vegas, Nevada, as Batista just continues to cinch that camel clutch in the lower back and on the neck of Valvina.
Well, if Valvina does not get out of this soon, they're going to be sending him back to Las Vegas, Nevada in two pieces.
Well, Val is trying to fire himself up and does have one arm loose and going after
that
second
one. Free. There he goes. Now he might have a chance. No, another brutal crossface.
And now big right hand to the side of the head of Valvina by Batista.
Now cover him. Hello.
Al, what a shock. Nobody wants to listen to you tonight.
Apparently not. Nobody wants to listen to you either, especially after what you did to Eugene. You know what? I'd be happy to see you in a Hell in a Cell with Eugene,
well,
instead of Triple
happen.
H and Shawn Michaels, even though that's going to be a brutal killer match. Oh, another killer suplex.
Another suplex by Batista. Could this one be over? Cover on again. Gets that left shoulder up, but a rather lackluster cover that time by the big man.
Valvina is not the type of opponent with his numerous years of experience. He's traveled the world before he came to WWE. You can't take him lightly.
And now still working that lower back as he's been doing throughout this matchup. And those powerful forearms into the lower back of Val Venis continuing to wear the big Valboski down.
Well, you can see that the experience that he's picked up from Triple H and with Ric Flair has been paying off, because they have shown him and taught him, stay focused once you get something hurt. But Val Venis put the boot to Batista's face. Batista taking too much time.
Way too much time, and here's a cover roll by Val Venis. A little cover, 1-2, oh, and a kick out at the last second by Batista.
That was a little low.
Well, Batista apparently was just made mad by Val Venis, and now,
Val Venis, though, powering out. Boy, lucky for him, because if Batista had hit that, that'd have been all she'd have wrote. Oh, neck breaker.
Nice neck breaker by Val Venis, and what a huge win this would be.
And Val,
you'd have to consider this an upset.
Look at the pain in Val's back. He can't capitalize, can't bring it up, but he's fighting all it forward. Val, big mistake, man. Don't go to the top rope. I know you're trying to, no.
Well, Val Venis is going to the top rope, Al. Batista, though, right back up to his feet, not allowing the big Valboski to land that money shot.
Brutal right hands by Batista. Those things got to feel like just soup bones hitting you upside the head.
This is also a man who does not go to the rope very often, even the middle rope, but there you go.
Standing superplex in the second rope.
Not in the arsenal of Batista, but pulling it out here tonight. And Batista, so impressive, as he is each and every week, and now just stalking the big Valboski.
Valboski looks like he got a little bit of nerve damage. His hand flexing. Oh, nope, this could be it. Don't hit it. That's it. He's done.
Forget about it, Al. You can make the count, whatever you want to call it. You can call it a victory by Evolution's Batista.
Here is your winner, Batista.
I'll tell you what I call it, Coach. I call it impressive.